It's Michelle from Lab Muffin Beauty Science, Chemistry PhD, Beauty Product Nerd, and today we are busting hair care myths. I usually bust beauty myths for free, but today's video is sponsored by Pantene. Even though it is sponsored, everything is my own opinions and research. Unfortunately, since they're paying me, they expect me to actually do work. We're going to start by looking at the scrape test. I don't know if you remember, but back in the day, I did a video debunking this section from 5 Minute Crafts. They scraped off some white stuff on hair with scissors and talked about how hair products worked. It turns out that this test isn't just some wacky 5 Minute Crafts exclusive, but it's actually used by hairdressers and people selling hair care products to convince you that there's silicones building up on your hair. So I thought I'd do a little experiment. I took two samples of hair, I washed both of these with clarifying shampoo that's meant to remove buildup, and I did this twice to really make sure I clarified the hair. Then I put Pantene conditioner on this one only. Usually when people do this scrape test, they talk about conditioner with silicones or just drugstore conditioners with silicones causing so-called buildup. There's usually a few myths around cheap drugstore versus expensive professional products involved. I blow dried both hair samples to about 90% dryness, then I let them air dry, I'm going to scrape them. Here's the Pantene one with silicones, lots of white stuff coming off. So if it's silicone buildup, we shouldn't see it with the hair that doesn't have conditioner. Here's the hair sample without conditioner. But we still get the white buildup coming off. If we look through my little handheld microscope, we can see what looks like microscopic grated Parmesan cheese curls. I guess this is a forbidden snack, but you could totally eat hair. And on both of these samples, we can see these long, clear, curly pieces. So it doesn't look like this white stuff is built up from conditioner. Otherwise, we firstly see no white stuff coming off the clarified hair sample with no conditioner, and we'd see a big difference in the sorts of residue coming off the two different samples. But I think these much more high-powered microscope images that Pantene scientists took of the residue tells us a bit more about what's going on. The structure of hair is like a cylinder. There's a cortex on the inside and cuticles on the outside. And it's actually the inside cortex that's colored, that's where all the pigment lives. And on the outside, the cuticle, this is the part that has that roof shingle structure that you've probably seen in diagrams, this is actually transparent. The white waxy residue, it is mostly just the cuticle getting scraped off. You can see the little roof shingles here. So this scraping test isn't a really good way to check for residue. And if you look at the microscopic images of the hair afterwards, this is what it looks like. It looks like a split end. This test is actually giving you split ends. This scrape test is actually super damaging, so don't do this at home with your own hair. And please don't let someone who you're paying to make your hair look nice do this to your hair either. So scraping hair with scissors doesn't show you whether or not products are building up on your hair. Now, premium salon hair care products versus drugstore products, specifically conditioners. There's a myth that drugstore conditioners leave buildup while salon products don't. But the truth is, all conditioning products leave stuff on and in the hair. This is fundamental to how they work. Hair is dead. The only living part is the part inside your scalp, the bulb. So the hair up near your scalp, the bit that's just come out of the bulb, this is really nice and neat, and it looks a bit like this under a microscope. But hair grows at about 14 centimeters per year. This is about 5.5 inches. That's down to around here. So by the time your hair reaches here, it's built up about a year's worth of damage. That's 365 days of brushing, washing, sun exposure, drying it with heat, straightening it with heat. And that's if you don't blast it with bleach like I did. Little bits get snapped off the outside of the cuticle, and it ends up looking a bit like this. So you can imagine the difference between how these two sections of hair feel. Closer to your scalp, it feels smooth. The longer it is, the rougher it gets. And then when you have these battered surfaces, when they smash against each other, then you get more and more damage. To make something battered feel smooth again, sanding it down and wearing it down even more isn't a really good approach. You have to add stuff back into the hair to plug up the gaps. And that's exactly what all conditioning treatments do. They fill in gaps, not just on the surface, but also deeper down. They fill in weaker spots where chunks have washed off or worn away. And all of this extra reinforcement makes hair more like the intact hair that was newer. It makes it smoother and stronger. If you look at the ingredients list of any hair conditioner out there, well, almost everyone, I'm sure there's one out there that breaks this rule, there is going to be a cationic surfactant. These have names like cetrimonium chloride, behentrimonium chloride, disterodimonium chloride, stearimidopropyl dimethylamine, and in the acidic pH of a conditioner, all of these have a positive charge, and that positive charge is really important because that's how they work. When hair is wet, it gets negatively charged. Opposite charges attract, and so these positively charged bits of the cationic surfactants stick to your negatively charged hair. The scientific term for this is adsorption. And the rest of the surfactant molecule is oily, and so your hair is now lubricated, it smooths it out, it reduces static. These cationic surfactants are the default active ingredients in conditioning products. There are lots of other conditioning ingredients too, polyquaternion polymers, hydrolyzed proteins, oils, and silicones. And it doesn't matter if they're in high-end luxury conditioners or if they're in those two-in-one shampoo and conditioner products that people with shorter hair tend to use, all of these work by sticking to hair. So some amount of buildup is good and necessary for any conditioner to actually work. But the amount of buildup is really tiny. These gaps in your hair are microscopic. You're not going to see these in a scrape test. So that brings us to the idea that a product is bad because it weighs down your hair. Now, what exactly determines how much of a conditioning ingredient sticks to and stays on your hair? Well, it depends on a number of factors. What the ingredient actually is, how you use the product on your hair, how much is in the product, what the overall formula is, how you use the product on your hair, and what your hair is actually like. And I think this is really why there's this perception that silicones can build up on your hair and weigh it down. If you use a product that's suited for someone else's hair on your hair, so if you use a product that's meant for coarse resistant hair on fine porous hair, then it can build up in your hair and weigh it down and make it greasy and lank and stick to dust. This actually happened to me right after the first time I bleached my hair. Before bleaching, my hair was stereotypical Asian hair. It was straight, black, not very porous. So I used an intensive repair conditioner that had lots and lots of dimethicone in it, and that worked fantastically. But after I bleached my hair, the same conditioner made my hair really limp and greasy. So it wasn't because my old conditioner was cheap and bad. It wasn't. My sister still uses it. I have lots of friends who still use it and love it. It just became the wrong product for my hair type. It's a lot like skincare products and skin type. If you're using products that were made for dry skin on oily skin, you're probably not going to have a good time. And it isn't like my hair just hates all silicones. That's another misconception. Silicones aren't all the same. There's a massive variety. I found that my hair loves products with different silicones like amodimethicone and bisaminopropyl dimethicone. These are silicones that have a positive charge, so they tend to deposit less on hair. Positive charges repel each other, so once there's enough silicone stuck to your hair, then extra stuff doesn't stick on as much, and so the chance of your hair getting overloaded with silicones is a lot lower. On top of this, the same name on an ingredient list could mean different substances. Going back to dimethicone, dimethicone is a silicone polymer that has oxygen and silicon atoms stuck together like this. But the polymer can have different lengths and still be called dimethicone, and these different lengths will have different properties. If it's longer, then the dimethicone will feel a bit thicker and heavier. If it's shorter length, then it can feel more lightweight and spread through hair a lot more easily. If you look at all the different ingredients that are called dimethicone that you can buy, you'll see that there are lots of different grades. And when I say grades, I'm not talking about higher and lower quality, I'm just talking about different dimethicones with different properties that are good for different uses. So sometimes looking at the ingredients list doesn't help as much as we'd like it to when we're looking for a conditioner that suits our hair. You need to look at what sort of hair the conditioner says it's for, look at reviews from other people with similar hair to you, and try it on your own hair. So the moral of the story is there are loads of different silicones, hundreds and thousands of them. They can be incorporated into hair care products in lots of different ways. Just because you've had a bad experience with one conditioner with silicones doesn't mean you need to give up on all silicones entirely. And if you do, you might be missing out on some really great products that will work really well on your hair. I hope this video helped you understand a bit more about what might be going on with your hair care products. Like, subscribe, notification bell, follow me on Instagram, check out my blog, and I will see you next time for, I don't know if it'll be sunscreen, but it will definitely be nerdy.